These are the cerebral hemispheres. They may look similar, but our hemispheres differ in size, shape, and function. Thus, even though the cerebrum is divided into two equal hemispheres, we now know that the left hemisphere processes information in a focused and analytical manner, and the right hemisphere integrates information in a more broad manner. We see that insights and solutions to ideas are more likely to occur in the right hemisphere. However, the hemispheres do not operate independently. Let's look inside so I can show you why this is. Here we have the corpus callosum. This is a thick band of fibers that connects the two hemispheres. And this band allows for extensive communication between the two hemispheres. This is really important for things such as logical thinking, even creativity. From research, we know that the biggest functional difference between the two cerebral hemispheres is language. Both speech and language abilities involve the left hemisphere. However, they involve different parts. The first neuroscientist to discover this was a man named Paul Broca. He found that a man who had a stroke could understand language, but could not speak grammatically correct sentences. This man had what we call aphasia, which is a deficit in the ability to speak or comprehend language. Due to his research, the part of the brain that's responsible for our ability to actually produce speech is named the Broca's area. The part of the brain that's responsible for the ability to speak in meaningful sentences and to comprehend the meaning of speech is named the Wernicke's area. It was discovered by Carl Wernicke. If there's damage to this area, the type of aphasia that results from this is fluent grammatical streams of speech. However, they have no meaning. So they're grammatically correct, they just don't have any meaning to them.